Hello, my friends, and welcome to another video. I know I didn't make very many videos in 2022, and I'm sorry for that. I hope to do better in 2023, but what I thought I would do in this video here today is go back and look at the images I got in 2022. I did get out and I did photograph a fair bit, and I got some that I'm pretty pleased with. I got 11, in fact, which reminds me of an Ansel Adam quote. Any 12 good photographs in any given year is a good crop. So I would say 11 out of 12, not too shabby. That's a quote that I used in my September newsletter, which if you're not signed up for, you should be. Links down below, so check that out. But I thought I would just kind of go through my 11 photos from 2022 and just share them with you. I have some video clips for some, because I did make a few videos, and others I don't have any video clip. But we'll just kind of do a little voiceover and describe the image and kind of what I was thinking when I captured it. So here we go. I hope you enjoy it. 2022, my photographic review. All right, that was a bit of a struggle to get my tripod set up on this scene, but we're here, we're set up now. And the shot's really simple. It's just this tree, it's this hollowed out tree that has snapped in half. So I've got this outer wrapping of bark, the outside of the tree. And then we're also seeing inside the hollowed out dark wood on the inside of this tree, set up in a vertical orientation to exaggerate that diagonal line of the snapped off tree trunk. And then the contrast of the light outer bark and the dark inner bark. Focusing on the outside bark to get that texture and that edge. I've got this gorgeous light coming in from behind, so it's kind of highlighting the edge of that thing. I am shooting at an ISO 100 f9 to try and get the inside and the outside of this tree sharp. And 1/6 of a second is about my exposure. I'm going to shield my lens here. Well, we got a little shade coming in now, it's not so necessary, but I've been shielding my lens from the sun to keep the flare off, and it's helping that contrast and the dark wood inside. Before, I was getting that lens flare before, and it was just kind of washing out the dark wood in the background. But that's the idea. 2-second timer, because the ground here, very soft and very spongy, so any movements kind of moves this thing. And after I spent like probably 5 minutes just getting my tripod where I want it, I don't want it to move. So 2-second timer, hands off, hold your breath, take the shot. We got that one. This image was a complete surprise, I'm not gonna lie. I got this one while I was on vacation with my wife in Santa Fe, New Mexico. This is taken in Bandelier National Monument, which is a beautiful park. And we had hiked out to the Lower Falls, and that's what this is an image of. This is the Lower Falls in Bandelier National Monument. And the water was not very intense that day. There wasn't a big, massive flow. So I didn't take a picture of the whole falls. I just got zoomed in on a little small section of it where I thought what water was falling was making an interesting pattern, and I just loved the texture and the coloration of the rocks, and it just kind of narrowing in into the middle there. And that's what this one is. It's a really simple little shot and unexpected, and I loved it. All right, a little bit of a shimmy shimmy shake, a shimmy shimmy shake out here to the river. Yeah, all right, this shot is really really simple, and I love it. This is beautiful rock in front of me. It's just this sheet rock. It's beautiful gold and black, and just super contrasty. And the water is literally just cascading in a sheet over the edge of it. So I'm shooting down, kind of, this is like a splitting the frame, kind of diagonally with the edge of this rock, and then the water cascading off the front. I am shooting this at an ISO 100 f8 4-second exposure. And I'm doing that 4-second exposure to kind of get rid of any of the glare of the water off of the rock. Polarizer is not really working here. Shooting straight down, sun's behind a cloud, which is helping me get rid of that shine off the rock surface. But then I've still got that beautiful kind of white, silver, shimmery water below it. So that's the shot. It's just really simple. Just love that kind of contrast between the rock and the flowing water. Kind of really abstract shot. You don't really know what you're looking at first. And I kind of enjoy that. So. All right. All right, so after a lot of futzing with the tripod, I was having a little trouble with the shadow of my tripod leg falling right through the middle of my seam. So it took a lot of little finagling, some adjusting, some wiggling, a little twisting and jiving to get it in here. I got it in here, got the shadow out, cloud rolled in, took away the shadow I wanted of the branch on the rock. So I'm just kind of waiting and hoping that sun pops back out a little bit. But the shot is really, really simple. It is just, as I mentioned, it's just this pebble in the middle of this branch growing out of this rock. And that's it. It's really, really simple. Ooh, Am I getting my light? I'm getting a little bit of my light. I'm gonna get this off real quick. Boom, there we go.
This image was a surprise, not so much because of the image itself, but because of where I was. I was on a trip in Houston, Texas, and I had chosen a random park on the map. I wasn't sure what I was going to find there, but I was not expecting full-blown swampland. But that is what I found. It had alligators and everything. Huge American lilies, egrets, all of the things you expect to see in a swamp. But it was in Houston, Texas. Well, just outside of Houston, Texas. But that just goes to show how little I know. But as I was walking along the trail, I could not help but notice all the algae and plant life that was growing up from below the surface of the water. It was as I approached an oak tree that I noticed this composition. The tree's reflection in the water and the plant life below the surface matched up perfectly with one another. So this image was just about me getting it all to line up through my lens. It's just such a simple image, but it makes you look at it twice, which is what I like about this one. I am kind of a sucker for shots like this. It's so simple. It's just this beautiful fall leaf trapped underneath the water. And I think what makes this one so much fun for me is that decayed leaf underneath it that's almost mimicking it perfectly and just acting like a shadow of the bright, colorful leaf on top of it. One of the things that kind of makes this one special for me is this was taken in Cuyahoga Valley State Park, which is where I started my YouTube videos. That's where I shot my very first YouTube video. And I was hoping to shoot a video on this day, but the water levels were so low that the falls were unimpressive. And I almost gave up and went home. But as I walked down the fall, just kind of looking around, there was this little leaf just sitting there, trapped under that small trickle in the bottom of the stream. And I'm glad it was such a small trickle, because if there were any more water than there was, this leaf would have washed away long ago. I like this image. I called this one Perception. There's this obvious eyeball pattern in the bark of this tree, and I just felt like this tree was kind of staring back at me and judging me for being there and wondering what I was doing. And it just reminded me of this great quote that a culture is no better than its woods. Just a nice little reminder that you can tell a lot about a society and how they care for the environment and everything around them. So it was just a really nice little moment to kind of stand there and be appreciative of this tree and the nature around me and this park that I was in, which was Eno State Park in Durham, North Carolina. Just a beautiful little park and just a great little spot to be. And it was a very good, very happy day. And I love this little image that I got on that day.
I think I like that one. Oh, I do like that one. Oh, this is a great shot. Fantastic. All right. So I found this great, perfect golden maple leaf laying on top of a wooden log, which is laying out over some water, over rocks. All of the things that I love right there. I'm zooming in tight on this to really just kind of just zoom in on that leaf, kind of just frame it out with rock on either side, and then the water just running through the middle of this frame. Shooting at an F11 ISO 100 circular polarizer to kind of remove a little bit of the glare. And a three-stop neutral density, which is currently giving me a 10-second exposure. Might be more than I actually want, so I might try to do a little bit shorter exposure and see what I think of that, but the shot's really simple and it's really pretty and I love it. And I'm glad I got the camera out of the bag.
and I'm taking my time as I walk through these woods and enjoy my day. Another just really pretty scene along this river. I've got this great little clump of rocks. A couple of little fall leaves have fallen on them. Water is cascading around them. That's it, really, really simple. Got a circular polarizer to reduce the glare off of the rocks. Shooting at an ISO 100, F11, 1.6 seconds again. Just a little over a second and a half. Little 2 second timer so that the camera settles, takes the shot. That's it. It's really simple. It's really pretty.
I don't know what I can say about this one. It's kind of my signature shot. It's water over rocks, and it's just a scene that I love so much. There's something about that juxtaposition between solid and liquid rock and water that I can't resist. And this one was so perfect. Just the warm orange and red tones in that rock and the cool blues of the water. It was just too perfect to resist. And I love this shot. It is so simple and so, I don't know, just elegant and kind of flowing. And I love it. Simple and easy and one of my favorite things to take a photograph of. What can I say about this shot? This one is just fun, and I got this one at the end of the day. I was actually packing up and heading out. I went down to the beach to try and get a sunset shot this day, but the clouds just did not cooperate. They just kind of all dissipated and fluttered off into nowhere. So I had given up. I thought it was it, we're done. I'm going home, and packed up my stuff. And as I was walking back towards the trailhead, I saw this rock off of the shore, just a little bit, maybe 15 or 20 feet out into the water, and it had fallen off into the shadow of this giant boulder, which gave that foreground water that kind of blue, cool look. And then it had those warm tones in the background, so it almost looked like a sunset. And just the slow shutter speed just kind of gave the top of the water that wispy, cloudy look. And it almost looks like the top of a mountain poking up through the clouds at sunset. And it's just a simple, fun little shot, and I love it so much.
And there you have it. My top 11 images from 2022. My personal favorites anyway. I want to thank you for sticking with me here to the end. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked any of those images and would like to purchase a print, they're available for purchase on my website at toddhphoto.com. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you'd like to see more, and share it with your friends. Anything you can do to help me out here on the channel, it just helps me grow. And if you'd like to help me out and support me in my work, please visit my Patreon page. I'll leave the links for all of these things down below, of course. But over there on my Patreon page, you get early access to my monthly newsletter. You get the free download of the image. And I also include a little before and after and a bit of behind the scenes and some of my editing techniques that I use in these images. So I hope that's just a little something extra for your support. So again, thank you for watching. Here's to looking forward to 2023. And hopefully everyone has a good, happy, and productive year. And we'll see you all soon. Thanks for watching.